students, today we have to discuss here solutions of quadratic equations by factorization. Means we have to calculate or we have to find out the solutions of the quadratic equations. So before understanding this one, we have to already study that this standard format of the quadratic equation. What is the standard format? Standard format of quadratic equation. So when we talk about the standard format of quadratic equation, we have to write like this: a x squared plus b x plus c is equal to 0. Okay, this is the standard format of the quadratic equation. So what is the maximum degree of this one? That is 2. That means the maximum index of the variable x is 2. So what is this? That means there are only 2 roots of this equation. Okay, maximum roots of this equation are 2. Why? Because the maximum index of x is 2 here. So therefore, maximum roots is equal to 2. So how to find out the roots of this equation, or how to find out the solutions of the quadratic equation? So we'll discuss here. So when we talk about the factorization, okay, when we talk about the factorization, so how to factor this equation? Any quadratic equation is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. Okay, so when we calculate the factors of the quadratic equation, we have to consider your b. What we have to consider? B. And this b is factorized. This b is factorized into two parts, that is b1 and b2. Okay? This b is factorized into two parts, that is b1 and b2. In such a way that when we add b1 and b2, we have to get b. Okay, when we add this b1 and b2, we have to get a b. Now, one more condition is there. When we multiply b1 with b2, then the result is a into c. A into c. Clear? Yes? Understand this one? This is the basic concept of this. We have to say that this one is the steps when we can do or when we factorize the quadratic equations or when we calculate the quadratic equation, quadratic equations roots. Okay, so how to do this one? So we have to understand this one with the help of an example. So this is the basic idea related to the find out the factors of the quadratic equation. This is important here. So we have to discuss here one example. One example we have to discuss: x square plus 7x plus 12 is equal to 0. And we have to find out the solution of this equation. So this equation is the quadratic equation. Why? Because this is present in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. Okay, this equation is present in the standard quadratic equation form. So, when we talk about this one, how to find out the roots of, we have to take the 7. And 7 is factorized into 2 parts. So, when we talk about the 7, when we add 1 and 6, we have to get 7. When we add 2 and 5, we have to get 7. And when we add 3 and 4, we get 7. So this is about the addition only. Means we have to check here only first condition. That means we have to check here only this condition. Clear? That means when we take 1 plus 6, we have to get 7. 2 plus 5, we have to get 7. 3 plus 4, we have to get 7. But what about the next condition? That is when we multiply a into b, we have to must get here a into c. Suppose I have to multiply 1 into 6. What we get? 1 into 6. That is 6. 2 into 5, 10. Then 3 into 4, that is 12. Understand this one? How to calculate this? Okay. So which term we have to use? Which numbers we have to use? That is, this one is the value. Why? Because it's an M. When we add 3 and 4, we get the 7. Okay, when we add 3 and 4, we get 7. When we multiply 3 and 4, what is the value of A of 1? A value is 1. Nothing means 1 is there. And then 12. So 1 into 12, 12 is there. So 3 into 4, 12. So this is the result of this one. A into C. Clear? A into C. Value of A here. Value of A here, 1 into 12. So therefore answer is 12. And by using these two numbers, we have to get or we have to satisfy the both conditions. Yes? Clear? So by using these two numbers, that is 3 and 4, we have to factorize this one. So how to write this? Clear? So how to write this one? X square plus, instead of 7x, we have to write down. We have to write down like this. 3 plus 4x plus 12, which is equal to 0. Okay? Now, x square plus, multiply this x throughout the bracket, that is 3x plus 4x plus 12. This 12 is written as 3 into 4, which is equal to 0. Then, x square plus 3x plus 4x. Then plus 3 into 4, which is equal to 0. Okay. Now group these two parts, this one and this one. So what do we see? This one in this first part, what is the which term is common here? That is x. So take out of the bracket. So x, when we take the x out of this one, then what is remaining? That is x of this one. Then 3x, instead of 3x, only 3 is there, plus 3. Clear? How do we find out this one? Now, plus sign put as it is. So for this one, which term is common here? That is 4, this one and this one. So 4, then x put it as it is, plus 3. Okay? Which is equal to 0. Now, next step. X plus 3, because this is common here, then another step, x plus 4, which is equal to 0. Clear up to this point? Now next. When we get like this, so we have to write down like that, okay? Like x plus 3 is equal to 0 or x plus 4 is equal to 0. Understand this one? X plus 3 is equal to 0, x plus 4 is equal to 0. Now next, x is equal to minus 3 or x is equal to minus 4. So these are the two solutions of your quadratic equation, x squared plus 7x plus 12 is equal to 0. So therefore finally we have to write down x is equal to minus 3 comma minus 4 or minus 4. Okay. So this is your final answer. So in this way, we have to find out the solutions of the of a quadratic equation by factorization. Okay. So if you want to write this, please take the screenshot of it. Now we will discuss the some more examples based on this. Okay. Next one. Solve the following quadratic equations by factorization. So we have to solve here the examples. Which is based on the factorization, how to factorize the given equation by using the what factorization method. So this is your related to the factorization. Okay. Now your first question is there, that is m square minus 14m plus 13 is equal to 0. These are the solved examples from your book. Okay. So, we have to discuss here how to solve this. So, this is the quadratic equation where because the maximum index of this one is 2 and only one variable is there, that is m. So, when we talk about this equation, when we find out the solution of this equation, so by using the factorization, we have to solve this. So, for solving this, we have to do first is what? We have to write down given equation as it is. Okay. Next step is what? When we have to factorize this 14 into two parts. Okay. So, how many ways we have to write this 14? That is 1 plus 13, we have to get 14. Okay. But we have to get a minus 14. Okay. So, when we talk about minus 14, when we add minus 1 with minus 13, what we get? When we add minus 1 with minus 13, minus 1, minus 13, what is the result? Minus 14. Clear? When we multiply minus 1 into minus 13, what is your result here? That is 30 plus 30. Okay. So, listen here. What is the value of A here? 1. So, 1 into 30, that is 30. That means we have to get a 30 itself. Okay. So, these two numbers satisfies the criteria when we factorize this 40. Which one? Minus 1 and minus 30. So, how to write this one? This is the rough work you should do. Now, when we talk about this one, m square minus, what we do here? That is, we have to write down what? 1 plus 30 m plus 30, which is equal to 0. Now, m square minus, minus 1 into m minus m. Okay, minus 30 m plus 30, which is equal to 0. And this 13 is written as 13 into 1, which is equal to 0. Understand this one? How to write this? Clear? Now, make the two pairs. Now, next. What is the common here? That is m. So, put m outside the bracket and inside bracket. When we take out the m from outside, then what is the remaining here? Only m is there. Then minus, if m is get outside, then what is your result? That is minus 1 is remaining. So, what we get? M into minus 1. Then minus. This 13 is common here. So, write down 13. Next, m minus plus minus, which is equal to 0. Clear? Now, next. M minus 1 and m minus 13 is equal to 0. Okay. Now, we have to write like this. M minus 1 is equal to 0 or m minus 13 is equal to 0. Now, next, what is the value of m? M is equal to 1 or m is equal to 13. Clear? So, these are the roots. How to write this? Therefore, 13 and 1 are the roots of the given quadratic equation. Of the given quadratic equation. Clear? Now, next question we have to discuss here, second one. That is 3x square minus x minus 10 is equal to 0. Okay, 3x square minus x minus 10 is equal to 0. So, when we solve this one, what is the coefficient of x here? 1. That means we have to factorize this one. But we have to get addition or subtraction, here 1, that is minus 1, and multiplication, that means b value is here, minus 1, and a into c, that is, what is the value of a, 3, what is the value of c, minus 10, that means we have to get here, minus 30, clear, means we have to get the multiplication is minus 30 and b value is minus 1. So, which two numbers we have to find out like this. So, just observe here, when we multiply minus 6 with 5 or when we add minus 6 and 5, what is the result? That is minus 1. Or when we multiply minus 6 with 5, what is the result? 6 5s are 30 and minus 6 is minus 30. That means these two numbers are following this criteria. Okay, that is minus 6 and plus 5. Clear? So, how to write this one? That is, next step is we have to write down like this term as it is, 3x square minus x minus 10 is equal to 0. Then 3x square minus 6x plus 5x minus 10 is equal to 0. Okay. So, now next 3x square minus 6x plus 5x, this 10 is written as what? 5 into 2 is 0. Now, group this term. So, what is common here? That is 3x. 3x common, then when we take the x out of 3x outside, then we have to get here x only. Then minus 2. 3 to the 6. Now plus 5x and 5 into 2. That means we have to get here 5. Then x minus 2 is remaining is equal to 0. Then x minus 2 is in one bracket and 3x plus 5 is in another bracket. Now next, x minus 2 is equal to 0 or 3x plus 5 is equal to 0. Then x is equal to 2 or what is this? We have to write like this. X is equal to minus 5 upon 3. Minus 5 upon 3. So therefore, minus 5 upon 3 and 2 are the roots of given quadratic equation. Okay. So, in this way we have to solve here the two examples which is based on the how to calculate the roots of quadratic equations. So, today we have to stop here. In next class, we have to discuss the practice set which is based on this one, that is practice set 2.2. Okay, so I hope you have to understand up to this point. So, please like it, subscribe it and share it to your friends. Thank you, students.